What's up, everybody? I'm Jesse Showalter, and in this episode, I want to talk about icons, because they're kind of a big deal. So in this video, I want to talk about what I think are important about icons, what you should be looking for in icons, and a couple of great resources for all of you icon lovers. Let's do it. Before we get started, this video is sponsored by Lord Icon, which is an amazing new animated icon set that's great for both your static designs, but also your websites and mobile applications. It's a library of over 1,200 animated, amazing icons that are all customizable. You can create collections and really bring a lot of life to your design. I'm gonna show you a little bit more about Lord Icon later on, but I just wanted to say, really cool stuff. Check it out. So here's my top three tips on what you should be looking for when you are looking for iconography. Number one, you need to look for something that is a little bit more unique. So you need to find things or customize things so they have a little bit of life to them. They're a little bit more interesting. You don't want to use that same tired icon that everybody's used over and over. It's important to bring a little bit of customization, a little bit of flash, and a little bit of uniqueness to your projects through your icons. Number two, you should also be looking for icon sets that bring consistency across the board. So not only do you want them to be unique, but you want them to be consistent. This means your style, your rounded corners, your stroke, your width, everything about them needs to be consistent throughout your design. We've all been to websites or used applications where the iconography looks like a yard sale. Don't let that be you. Don't let that be you. Third and final tip of the day, which I think is actually the most important, is that your icons need to make sense. They need to communicate what it is that they're representing, and they need to do it quickly, clearly, and look good while they're doing it. For instance, what kind of icon do you use for a tab that has the word home on it? Probably a little house, most likely. You might do something a little bit different, but home, house, it makes sense. If people have to tap a settings tab, they're most likely looking for a gear icon. If you're looking for mail or messages, it's probably a little paper airplane or an envelope. You don't have to get so unique and so customized and so out there that the icons no longer make sense. They need to communicate quickly and clearly. So Lord Icon is great because it's an animated icon library. It has over 1,200 animated icons. You can see I can roll over them and get animations for each one of them. I can search through all the icons. I can edit them. I can download them. I can customize them. And then I can embed them into my projects, whether that's a mobile project or a website project. So maybe I really, really love this confetti. I can just come in here and I can either add it to a collection, download it, or take it to the full editor, which I'm gonna do right now. I head over to the full editor inside of Lord Icon. This is insane. You have your primary color and your secondary color. So maybe I want like a little bit of a lighter black or gray for my primary, but my secondary, I want it to be not green, but instead I want it to be like purple or something. We could do something like that. So that's our colors. We can change the stroke width. So you can make it really chunky, really, really light, in the middle, whatever you want. You can add it into the collection. And then you can set the trigger, and it's going to give you some previews down here. So right now it's on loop. So you can see it's just on loop. It's going, it's going, it's going. We can set it to hover instead. So now look, when you hover over it, you're going to get the animation. You can actually download this as JSON and hand this off to a developer, and they can implement it using Lottie. You can go to Lottie files and upload it there, rework it if you want. You can embed it using the HTML. To embed this into your website, all you have to do using HTML is just drop this JavaScript tag that leads back to Lord Icon, and then put that in the head of your project. And then you want to copy and paste this Lord Icon tag and drop that inside of whatever area you want the icon to show up at. And it has all of the parameters. It's a looping, here's the primary and secondary, here's the stroke, the scale, and the style. And then we can just copy this entire code and plop it right in. It's really, really simple, really easy. The other options are you can download this as a GIF, a static SVG, or a static PNG if you want to drop that into maybe your Figma file as a GIF so we can see things animating right there inside. What's also really, really cool is later on, if you love that color palette, that width, that stroke, everything that you did, and maybe you want something like this alarm clock or this takeaway coffee, we're gonna click on takeaway coffee. I'm gonna load my previous settings and it pops them right into place. Look, the stroke updated, everything updated, and that's absolutely amazing. So maybe we also want to update This handshake is really, really cool. Let's go load those settings. And it went ahead and loaded it, and we can add it to that party collection. Now we're creating a collection of animated icons we can embed in our projects, whether it's on the web or inside of a design tool. Well, that's it. Those are some of my biggest tips for iconography, as well as some of my favorite resources for icons. You can check the link down in the description. You'll find a link for Lord Icon, which sponsored this video today, as well as some of those other iconography resources. Check those out down in the description. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. I do lots of videos about design and development and iconography, just like this one. So maybe stick around by hitting that little subscribe button and that little bell notification icon so you know when another video like this one comes out. I hope you're having an amazing week. I hope you're designing amazing things. I hope you're making amazing things. And I hope that you're using small things like icons to make a big impact in your work. I'll see you in the next one.